Next theorem. 1.2.13. Let F maps A to B, G maps B to C, B bijections. Then G circle F maps A to C is a bijection. So we know the definition of the bijection. What is meant by the bijection? If a function is both injection as well as surjection, then it is called a bijection. So that means we have to prove that G circle F is injection as well as surjection, we have to prove. So that means here prove, first to prove G circle F is an injection, this is first step. Let us prove it. Let A1 comma A2 belongs to A. That implies G circle F of A1 equal to G circle F of A2. Already we have discussed the definition of G circle F of X. This we can write G circle G of F of A1 equal to G of F of A2. So now G is bijection. Bijection means injection only. So we can write F of A1 is equal to F of A2. Since F is a bijection, so that implies A1 is equal to A2. So if you consider G circle F of A1 is equal to G circle F of A2, then A1 is equal to A2. Therefore, G circle F is an injection. Let us prove G circle F is a surjection. So now consider three sets A, B, C. This is a function, this is G. This is, we know that A to C, G circle F. Consider element A, element B, element C. Since F maps A to B is a surjection, there exist an element B belongs to B such that F of A is equal to B for every A belongs to A. G maps B to C is a surjection, bijection means surjection also. There exists an element, C belongs to C, such that G of B is equal to C. So consider R. Say now C is equal to G of B. This is G F of A. By definition, we can write G circle F of A. Here also, therefore, G circle F is a surjection. Now G circle F is injection as well as surjection. Hence, G circle F maps A to C is a bijection. Next theorem. Theorem. Let F maps A to B, comma G maps B to C be bijections. Then G circle F inverse is equal to F inverse circle G inverse. So that means G circle F inverse is equal to F inverse circle G inverse. Both are equal functions we have to prove. So in order to prove these two are equal functions, means they must define on the same domain and they should have the same range, then these two functions are said to be equal functions. So first let us prove. So now let us consider three sets A, B, C. This is F function, this is G function. Say element A, B, C. Now G circle F. Since F maps A to B is a surjection, that implies F of A is equal to B, F of A is equal to B. Therefore, F inverse B is equal to A. Inverse exists since it is a surjection. Since G maps B to C is a bijection, that implies G of B is equal to C. Therefore, G inverse C is equal to B. And also, F inverse B to C, F inverse B to A, and G inverse C to B are also bijections. Since F maps A to B, G maps B to C are bijections. G circle F is also a bijection. So we have G circle F of A is equal to C. That implies G circle F inverse of C equals to A. Say equation 1. We have F inverse circle G inverse of C. This we can write F inverse of G inverse C. G inverse of C is equal to B. So this is F inverse B. So F inverse of B is equal to A. This is equation 2. So G circle F whole inverse of C is same A. F inverse circle G inverse of C is A. From 1 and 2, G circle F whole inverse is equal to F inverse circle G inverse.